Hello, welcome to our channel for rprogramming. In this video, we will show how to implement binomial distribution in R. So we know binomial distribution is related to a so-called Bernoulli process. So an experiment can be called a Bernoulli process if it has the following properties. So the experiment consists of repeated trials, and each trial results in an outcome that may be classified as a success or a failure. And for each trial, there is a probability of success called P remains constant from trial to trial, and the repeated trials are independent from each other. And the number of success in n Bernoulli trials is called a binomial random variable. And the probability distribution of this discrete random variable is called binomial distribution. It can be denoted by BXNP. The formula to calculate the probability for binomial is the combination of NX times the p's x power and the q's n minus x power, where q equals 1 minus p. And x can be discrete random variable from 0 to n. And the binomial distribution's mean equals n times p, and the variance equals n times p times q, so where q equals 1 minus p. So next, we will show how to do binomial distribution in R programming. So in R programming, for the statistics functions, there is the combination of an alphabet DPQR, one of these four alphabet DPQR, then plus an abbreviation of this distribution. So for binomial distribution, for example, here we use the d binom function to calculate the probability for the random variable x in n trials. So for example, d binom 3 size equals 10, prob equals 0.2 will calculate the binomial distribution of the random variable occurring 3 times of 10 Bernoulli trials and with a success rate 0.2 for each trial. So this probability is about 0.20. Next, for example, we will create a vector of probabilities associated with random variable from 0 to 10 in the total 10 trials with the same success rate. So we will see what's the probability for this random variable. Next, we'll plot can see for 0 to 10, this is the probability because the mean value for the, in this case is 0.2 times 10 equals 2. So of course this is the highest probability for the variable 2, right? And 0 about 0.1. And for the 1, random variable 1 is about 0.27, right? And the variable larger than 6 probability is almost 0. And next, the function is called p binom. So this function is used to find the cumulative probability of a data following binomial distribution to a given value. So which means p binom kmp will calculate the cumulative probability for random variable less than or equal to k in this binomial distribution. So p by norm 3 size 10 plot 0.2 will calculate the random variable or the success times x occurring less than or equal to 3 times among total 10 trials with the probability 0.2 for success in each trial. And again, we will plot this probability, cumulative probability, as the cumulative probability is not decreasing a function for the random variable. So you can see upon about 4, random variable 4, there is very little increasing in the function. So which means the probability for these values, each values is about 0, because so it's almost no increasing after value 4. And the third function is called Q by norm. This is used to find the nth quantile. This is actually the opposite function for the P norm. So Q norm will find the random variable of X given a cumulative probability. So its formula is Q by norm with a probability P of n trial. And this is the same as before for the success rate. So Q by norm 0.879, for example, and size 10, 0.2 for the plot will calculate the random variable X associated with a cumulative probability of 0.879. So it's three. And similarly, we can calculate a series of random variable X associated with a series of probability between 0 and 1 using Q by norm function. So this is the random variable. So for the cumulative probability from 0 to 1, the random variable is 1.11 and 2.2334, right? So, and over 4 is increased very quick for random variable, because there is almost no cumulative probability increase of these random variables change, which means the cumulative probability does not change, and this random variable's discrete probability is almost zero. And last function we will show for binomial is R by norm, which is quite easy. It just means to generate random variable associated with this binomial distribution. So here, for example, R by norm 8 will generate 8 random variables from a binomial distribution with n trial and success rate is 0.2. So here you can see the 8 discrete random number 4, 2, 2, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1 are generated. It's 100% random. And you can also, for example, generate 1,000 such numbers and plot it in histogram. So this is actually the shape is very close to the binomial probability distribution, right? Because this histogram represents the frequency. Frequency is actually a counterpart. If we divide it by the total number, this is the probability, right? And you can also download the source files to practice by yourself in rstudio by finding this link to get the R file. And all the videos for the R programming with statistics will be uploaded later. Thanks for watching.